So today let's make a quick video about what's inside of this battery pack for a power tool or cordless drill or something like this. Basically for some battery operated tool. And I found it just thrown on the ground. So I took it because I was interested what's inside of it and I also wanted to show you. And there are 4 screws in it. I already removed 3 of them and 1 remains. And but also let's take a look at the marking of it. There is positive and negative terminal, which goes into the tool basically. 4 screws, the marking 14.4 volts. It says cadmium, so it's probably nickel cadmium batteries, not lithium ion. And some other marking, which also says 14.4 volts DC, nickel cadmium, yes, recycle, maximum 40 degrees Celsius. Don't put it into a rubbish bin. So they just put it on the ground, basically. Don't put it into a fire and don't give it to fish. Interesting. And now let's take a look inside of it. Let's remove the last screw, which one it was. This one, and of course, this is a quick video. And so I can use just one hand, the other one holds the phone, of course. And for those quick videos, I'm using the phone instead of the camera because it has the pause function. I can pause the recording and then resume it and it continues into one video file. And let's try to open it to see the internals. Well, and that's it. There are the cells in it. There is 3 and 4 and 3, 10. But there are another 2 in this plug. So it's in total 12 cells. And 12 times 1.2 volts makes 14.4 volts, as it says, where it says here. So it's 12 cells in series. And let's see the marking of it. Focus. And it's 1.2 volts. 1200 milliamp hours, and it's probably nickel cadmium, and it seems quite rotten, but I think it's not the batteries leaking, it's more like it was raining into it. It was just outside, thrown on the ground, so it probably rained into it. And those batteries look quite horribly. Could they be reusable or not? But of course those nickel cadmium batteries in those older battery packs for the tools tend to have paper isolation instead of plastic isolation. It's probably because it's more heat resistant, but it soaks water. So it's a horrible mess now. Not sure if it's reusable. It's basically 12 cells in series and nothing else. There is no protection, no temperature sensor, nothing. No balancing. But of course nickel cadmium cells don't need a balancing because the one that's charged more will just dissipate the extra energy if you keep it charging. And basically all of them will dissipate the extra energy if you keep charging it after it's already charged. And the balancer is not necessary, and also any protection is probably not necessary because those batteries don't really mind discharging them to zero, basically. Nickel cadmium batteries are way less delicate than lithium ion batteries. And I tried connecting a motor to some of the cells and it was turning. Now it's not. Well, it's just one cell. 1.2 volts, still turning, a 12 volt motor. So some of the cells are maybe still good. Should I try to reuse some? Maybe if I remove those paper isolations and give it maybe some Teflon tape on it, Kapton tape, and I could reuse it because I have some old nickel cadmium tools which use 2 or 4 cells only. So if some of the cells are good, I could reuse it maybe. A little autopsy of it, and it's basically a chain of 12 cells. It can be reorganized into a different shape. and the paper isolation is taken off, and some of them are rusted, some of them are actually quite nice looking, and I will probably trash those rusted ones and try to charge those not rusted, and of course the rusted ones will go into a dangerous waste. I will save it for my next trip to a junkyard. Those shouldn't go into a normal waste, because they contain cadmium. You will try to charge the good ones. And it's quite easy to charge nickel-cadmium batteries. You just basically connect a constant current. You don't have to care about the termination of the charging, and you can charge it using a DC current or a pulsing current, basically just a normal transformer, a bridge rectifier and a resistor for current limitation, or even just a single diode and a resistor for current limitation. So I divided it into basically the non-rusty ones and the rusty ones, and conveniently the non-rusty ones are basically in one chain of five, and strangely, this side of it is not rusted and the other side of it is completely rusted, and it's probably because this side of it is negative, and basically the negative potential on it made it rust less, and those ones are all on the positive side, and the positive voltage on it made it rust more in moisture, which makes sense. It basically looks like an electrolytic corrosion, which happens on the positive terminal, basically. And this is also why you put some sacrificial anode or on some things to basically prevent them from corrosion. You put sacrificial anode, for example, on ships, or you put a zinc coating on iron to prevent it from rusting, because the zinc will corrode before the iron does. So let's try to give it a quick charge using my bench power supply. And it's charging at 1.2 amps, which is 1C for the batteries. So it's a quick charge actually, and the cells are 1.4 volts each. And the voltage is roughly the same for all. And it seems to be charging. So let's keep it charging for a while, and nothing is hot, everything is cool. And it's charged, and it works nicely. I will choose the best four pieces and give it some Kapton tape as an isolation and make it a small battery pack, 4.8 volts, for my small power drill. And of course I'm starting to make a video about this power supply.